الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. نسأل الله العزيز الغفار أن يجيرنا وإياكم من عذاب النار. أما بعد، ما زلنا في شرحنا لأحاديث رياض الصالحين الإمام النووي رحمه الله تعالى، وذلك بشرح العلامة ابن عثيمين رحمه الله ورحم الله الجميع. ونحن في حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها، إذ قال النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم: لا هجرة بعد الفتح ولكن جهاد ونية، وإذا استنفرتم فانفروا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, we still on that, this particular hadith, the hadith of Aisha, where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, there is no real migration after the conquest of Mecca, but it is jihad, striving for the sake of Allah Ta'ala and an intention. And if you are called upon to strive for the sake of Allah, then you should do so. Like I said, the same hadith was narrated by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. And we started talking about, we talked a little bit yesterday about the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Mecca to Al-Medina, getting away from the Kufar of Quraysh, where they were trying to harm him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the fact that he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came back victorious 8 years later to conquer Mecca. And if you remember, we said that, you know, according to what the Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala said, that this hadith does not mean that, subhanAllah, that people that could not still migrate for the sake of Allah Ta'ala. This migration from Mecca to Al-Madinah was special. It's an absolute proportion that the Sahaba did, leaving all of their belongings and their homes and everything they owned, and they went with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to Al-Madinah. So this, the honor of this particular migration, of course, nobody can get it after Mecca became a place of Islam. But subhanAllah, other types of migration are still available, and the biggest of which is to leave the transgressions and the sins behind, and leave the kufr, leave the shirk, and going towards Islam, towards the righteous deeds. That is also a type of migration, and based on the hadith that I mentioned to you yesterday, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Al-Muslimu man salima al-Muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi, wal-Muhajiru man hajara ma harrama Allah." The real Muslim is the one that the other Muslims, in another narration, the people are safe from his tongue and his hand. And the real migrant for the sake of Allah is the one that migrates that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made forbidden. And the one other dalil that subhanAllah shows that migration will not be over until the signs of the end of days will start appearing, the hadith of Muawiyah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تنقطع الهجرة حتى تنقطع التوبة, that hijra, migration for the sake of Allah ta'ala, will never be over until the tawbah, the repentance, will be over. And وَلَا تَنْقَطِعُ التَّوْبَةُ حَتَّى تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسُ مِنْ مَغْرِبِهَا. And tawbah, repentance, will never be, I mean, the door of repentance will never be closed until the shams, the sun rises from the west, subhanAllah, one of the signs of the end of days. But subhanAllah, one thing I want just to get out of the way quickly, the main difference between the minor signs and the major signs of the end of days. يعني علامات الساعة, we call them in Arabic علامات الساعة, the signs of the hour. The Prophet spoke about them extensively, and he spoke about two types. He said, he talks about the minor ones, the minor signs, and the major signs. And one of the biggest minor signs, and one of the first that he mentioned, is Allah Ta'ala sending him as a prophet and a messenger. That's one of the minor signs of the hour. And he mentioned over 90 different signs in different ahadith, the majority of which have already happened. But subhanAllah, the main difference between the minor sign, الفرق بين علامات الساعة الصغرى والعلامات الكبرى, فرق شاسع جوهري. It is an important difference. When the minor signs appear, and the majority of them have appeared, the door of repentance remains open. But once the very first sign, and you said by the scholars that the very first sign is the sun rising from the west, when that sign appears, that the door of repentance will be closed forever. This is very, very important. SubhanAllah. So that is why, SubhanAllah, يعني the, when it comes to repentance, it is something that the believer has to be very quick, be very hasty in going towards, especially that the scholars tell you, whenever Allah Ta'ala and His Messenger give an order, and they don't give a timeline on it, then it means it has to be done right away. And a tawbah, repentance, is one of those things you'll find that Allah and His Messenger always talk about, that it has to be done right away. That's why it is important for us to repent from our sins on a daily basis, because we don't know when that day is going to arrive. We'll wake up, we'll find that the sun has risen from the other side, and that will be one of the clear signs that from the unseen, the door of repentance will be closed forever. And this is subhanAllah one of the things that this hadith mentions, the fact that subhanAllah tawbah, there will be no more tawbah, no more repentance once that takes place. Now subhanAllah, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala said that Mecca, of course, for the longest time was under the rule of al-mushrikeen, the idol worshippers of Mecca. They kicked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and 8 years later he came back victorious. So Mecca became a house of Islam. SubhanAllah, then that door of migrating from it to Al-Medina and getting that benefit and getting that reward was closed. And he said this hadith also is a dalil, is a proof that Mecca will remain a place of Islam until the end of days, or until the day that Allah Ta'ala wills. إِلَى مَا يَشَاءُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. And subhanAllah, there will be one day that there will be no more believers, no more people that say that إِلَهِ اللَّهُ on the face of the earth. And subhanAllah, this is after the Dajjal comes out, and Isa alayhi salam comes out, and he takes care of Dajjal, gets rid of him, lives on the earth for about 40 years. And after Isa alayhi salam, Allah Ta'ala takes care of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, Gog and Magog, in the time of Isa alayhi salam, then subhanAllah, there will come a gentle breeze that will take the souls of all the believers left on the face of the earth, and what will remain is Shirar al-Khalq, the most evil of the people, the ones that don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as-sa'ah, the hour will come on them. In that particular time, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that there will be a person from Al-Habasha, Abyssinia, that will come and actually destroy the Kaaba. He will break it down brick by brick, and he and the people with him are some of the people that the hour, the scary things of the hour will happen while they're then they'll be able to witness them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to make us from such people. Then in hadith, the Prophet said, وَلَكِنْ جِهَادٌ وَنِيَّةٌ, but it is a jihad, striving for the sake of Allah ta'ala, and an intention. And of course, nowadays, because of the media, this particular word became something scary. Everyone talks about it as something evil. Well, this is, subhanAllah, is a one of the most noble thing that a person can do, but if it's understood in the proper way. Of course, we have these groups, these crazy groups that claim to be the ones, they claim to be the ones carrying the flag of Islam, and all they're carrying the flag of is, subhanAllah, the very opposite of Islam, the very opposite of what the Prophet came to call to. They carry a flag of brutality and bloodshed and crimes, and they claim to be the ones, subhanAllah, striving for the sake of Allah Ta'ala. We know, they talk about them in the media all the time. I don't like to mention their names, but we know who they are. SubhanAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rid us of all of them as they tarnish the reputation of this tremendous religion. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is innocent of them. They are part of a khawarij that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us about, that came out. Some of them actually started showing their ugly heads in his time, and they got even stronger after his time. So I said that they're part of the subhanAllah, or at the root of the majority of al-fitan, the trials and tribulations that this ummah went through. They are people that show brutality. Their first target is Muslims. They subhanAllah, they murder Muslims first. And they say that they're doing it to carry the flag of Islam and the flag of Jihad. And Islam and the word Jihad in its proper sense is innocent of them, as the Prophet Sallallahu is. So, ثم قال الإمام ابن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى يعني الأمر بعد هذا الأمر الذي يعني the one thing that should, what was done after migration was over, was the call of al-jihad, calling for, striving for the sake of Allah Ta'ala. And he's talking about the people of Mecca, the first people from Mecca that accepted Islam. They went out with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam into a famous battle, the battle of Hunayn. And subhanAllah, it just happens that the Shaykh in the second rak'ah, he happens to be in Surah Al-Tawbah, and he spoke to us, and he recited actually the verses that speak about this battle. This is the battle that took place right after the conquest of Mecca. The Prophet ﷺ remained in Mecca 19 days. Then, subhanAllah, some people from the tribe of Hawazin and Thaqif, they got together and they decided to put an army together in order to attack the Prophet ﷺ and the companions. So the Prophet ﷺ heard of it, and he, with the 10,000 that came in with him to conquer Mecca, and another 2,000 that just became Muslims from Mecca, they put this army together of 12,000, and they went out to this place, to Hunayn. SubhanAllah, Awf ibn Malik was the leader of this army of Thaqif and Hawazin, and he said that we're going to go out and we're going to take our wives with us and our children and all our wealth, meaning that we're going to take them with us to the battlefield. This way there's no turning back. We're going to, you know, be fierce, and we're going to, you know, die to battle to our last breath. Even though some of the wise people of their tribe said not to, and they said this is a crazy idea, but he insisted. So he devised a plan to counter the Prophet ﷺ and the Sahaba. He said to, because there was a valley and mountains, he said to a lot of his army to hide in whatever caves and different places where a person can hide in the different mountains, and when to be invisible completely until the army comes face to face with the other army, and they should start, you know, throwing arrows at the Prophet and the Sahaba. In the meantime, something happened, subhanAllah, two things. The first thing is that those new Muslims, they still have no knowledge, they're still ignorant about this deen, still have a lot of things left from Jahiliyyah. They rode by a tree that the mushrikeen, the idol worshippers, used to almost worship. But when they go to battle, they will hang their swords on it, and they think it brings them luck, it brings them victory. So they said to the Prophet ﷺ, اجعل لنا ذات أنواط كما لهم ذات أنواط. Make us that tree was called ذات أنواط. So they said to the Prophet ﷺ, make us a tree like that, that we can hang our swords and it will bring us victory. So the Prophet ﷺ said, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You are saying exactly what Banu Israel said to Musa alayhi salam, اجعل لنا آلهة إلها كما لهم آلهة. Make a deity, a god for us as they have a god. And this, by the way, ya ikhwa, right after they saw Musa alayhi salam, this is Banu Israel, the Israelites, hit the Red Sea with his staff, and the Red Sea opens, and Allah Ta'ala put 12 different passages for each tribe. There were 12 tribes, and each one of their passages were completely dry. A complete miracle from Allah. Imagine, a sea opens, your passage is dry, and they each have a wall, subhanAllah, of water. They see it standing, it doesn't splash on them. Not only that, each passage in the water had windows where they can see each other. Because they were people that were very fearful for their lives, they actually could see each other through the different passages that they went through. Tremendous miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They cross over. Then Fir'aun crosses as well. And Allah ta'ala causes the sea to crash on Fir'aun and his army and to drown them. And they saw Fir'aun, that they themselves believed that he was a deity. They thought that he was invincible. They were all so afraid of him. They saw him drown, and actually the sea dragged him to shore, and they saw him dead, subhanAllah. Allah Ta'ala gave proof that this guy you thought he was invincible, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused him to die. It gave him every proof to have complete certainty in Allah and have tawheed. They walked for a little bit longer, a little bit later, and they found people that were worshipping. They were worshipping some idols, and said, "Ya Musa, oh Musa, just like they have idols, we want you to make us an idol." Subhanallah. لذلك قال الله عز وجل في سورة البقرة: "أم تريدون أن تسألوا رسولكم كما سئل موسى من قبل?" You want to ask your messenger as Musa was asked before? He was asked to make him an idol. That's the first incident. The second incident, subhanallah, is the fact that, subhanAllah, the Sahaba, especially some of the new Muslims, they said, today there is nobody that can beat us. Today we're 12,000. 12,000 back then was a huge number. They said, no, we could not possibly be beat today, subhanAllah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught them a lesson in this battle of Hunayn. A lesson about which I will talk to you tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the ones that always see the signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends their way and follow them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you and I from the true followers of Muhammad. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. الحمد لله رب العالمين وجزاكم الله خيرا.